8 weather.
All right, we have a lot of information to go over. First and foremost, it's been snowing throughout the day for a good portion of our western counties, and that transition is starting to move through the Cass County area as we speak. Now, a report from Eric Whitehill, who is now traveling back from western parts of Cass County, where we had a semi tipped over in the ditch. We had cars in the ditch. It's very slippery out there just west of the FM area. He says that basically the rain-snow change is happening in the Castleton area. By the time you get out towards Ayer, it's all snow and very slick. Now, that transition continues tonight. Some areas already reporting 7 inches of snow. We could have some spots with 12. Widespread snow tomorrow with heavy wind picking up throughout the day, creating blizzard conditions in the Devil's Lake Basin and beyond, possibly. As we go through the day, we're expecting lofty snowfall totals and downright dangerous conditions. Continuing into Saturday, as the snow eventually wraps up a little bit as we go through the day. Here's the warning for the blizzard now. This is in the Devil's Lake Basin. That's until Saturday later in the day. Now we have a winter storm warning throughout the remainder of the Red River Valley counties into western Minnesota. And then out to the east here, where we're not sure exactly the quantity of snow we're expecting here. However, we have a watch in place because you could see some elevated snow totals in a few of those counties that would meet watch or warning criteria. So holding on to 33, 1 degree above freezing. And when you look into the lights here in the FM area, it looks like that snow is transitioning as we speak. There's a big lull taking place right now. This was round one that made its way through, dumping over an inch of rain in many locations. Al reporting over an inch in the Horace area. Thanks, Al. As we take a look, here is the next wave starting to push its way rapidly north. That's enhancing the snow in and around the Bismarck area. And that enhancement of snowfall is going to move into our area as we go through the overnight hours. Here is a look at some photos sent in today. And this was a little bit earlier. 3 inches fell very quickly. Gene capturing this. That was in Hatton. All right, here's a look at the forecast. That snow, heavy, heavy snow at times by daybreak in the northern Red River Valley. And the wind begins to pick up first thing in the morning, where you see the red arrows here. We could have gusts upwards of 50 miles per hour. And as we go through the afternoon, that continues. Notice that snow wraps all the way back down around where the wind speeds are a little lower down here in the southern valley. The oranges would indicate gusts of up to and around 40 miles per hour. Later in the day, those winds will push into the southern valley. The snow continues, and later in the day on Saturday, we expect things to start wrapping up a little bit as this system starts to weaken and dry out. So we have the heaviest snow and wind between Friday morning up north and Saturday morning as we go through the day. That's when we'll have the most dangerous conditions for anyone to be out, and we'll show you snow totals. But right now, liquid moisture, in addition to what we have on the ground now, 1 to 2 more inches here in the Red River Valley, where you see the green colors, 2 to 3 inches in portions of the Devil's Lake Basin. So a lot of moisture left in the atmosphere from this system. Snowfall totals have shifted a little bit because on top of what we have now, we're expecting 5 to 9. Notice a little donut hole here near Fargo. We could have an enhanced amount in western Becker and Ottertail counties. Where you see purples, that's 8 inches to a foot. That does include the Grand Forks area. And then the real heavy shovel trouble and dangerous life-threatening situation, 1 to 2 feet plus where you see the pinks, and up near the international border, we could have some nearly 3 foot totals. 7 day planner looks like this. Friday into Saturday is when things will be at their worst, and late on Saturday, things start to wind down, but that does not mean travel will be easy anywhere as we have time to clean up from the storm. Sunday will be a little breezy. We could see some scattered flurries or light snow showers as we go through the day. And then finally, a little bit more sunshine as we begin and head through next week, Mike, as it looks a little bit better. But all in all, it's a dangerous storm system. And quite frankly, it's not often in October we see snowfall potential of around 30 inches of snow. It's a little bit over half of what you'd expect in this region for the entire winter season.
I was mowing my lawn last weekend.
Right.